Starship's belly flop landing is a very unique way of landing the rocket. The landing begins by first switching off the engine, falling from the sky belly first, or in the horizontal position. This is supposed to decrease the velocity as much as possible, then swinging back to a vertical position, lighting the two Raptor engines and land the tail down on its landing legs. This is much like a skydiver uses their arms and legs to control a free fall. When a skydiver falls belly first, they have the most drag on their body as possible, which means their terminal velocity is at a minimum. If they were to flip to their feet or head first, there would be much less surface area for the air to push against the skydiver. Similar, Starship can also control its terminal velocity. Think of the flaps as a skydiver's arms and legs. If the flaps are more extended, the drag on the vehicle will increase, and if they are folded in, the drag will decrease, thus making the terminal velocity faster. Those who don't know, terminal velocity is the maximum velocity attainable by an object as it falls through a fluid. Air is the most common example. It occurs when the sum of the drag force and the buoyancy is equal to the downward force of gravity acting on the object. Since the net force on an object is zero, the object has zero acceleration. That is, in our case, Starship. So, why not return, you know, vertically, like the Falcon 9? Falcon 9's first stage does not return from orbital velocity since it never goes to orbit. Starship is much faster than Falcon 9's first stage. Starship not only re-enters the orbital velocity, but in the future from interplanetary velocities as well. The only sensible way of shedding that much energy is to aerobrake. Aerobraking is free, whereas propulsive braking needs the same amount of energy as accelerating in the first place. That means you have to carry enough fuel for braking with you, which means you need to carry extra fuel to accelerate that fuel during launch, and extra fuel to accelerate that extra fuel, and so on. And because you need to carry fuel for braking, your spaceship will be even heavier than it would be when you aerobrake, so you need to shed even more energy, which means you need even more fuel, and this paradox continues. So, as soon as we have decided to use aerobraking, it becomes immediately obvious that you want to point the side with the most wind resistance into the flight path, and that is the broadside of the ship. Going full broadside first gives you the maximum deceleration, but it also generates the maximum heat and puts more stress on your crew and vehicle. On the other hand, you get out of the heat faster. Whereas if you re-enter at an angle, in our case, some 60 degrees, you allow the body to generate lift and thus stay longer in the thinner parts of the atmosphere and bleed off velocity there, where there is less air resistance and thus less heating. It also generates a gentler acceleration profile for the crew, cargo, and vehicle. But the entry takes longer, and thus, while the temperatures are lower, the vehicles are heated longer. Also do note that only the first stage or the booster of Falcon 9 lands. The second stage is expended precisely because it goes so much faster and has so much more energy to shed that there is no proper way of making it reusable. And Starship is, of course, the second stage of Starship Super Heavy system. So comparing it to the first stage of Falcon 9 doesn't really make sense. So now, coming to Super Heavy, Elon said that it will not land like a Falcon 9 booster, but SpaceX will try to catch it, essentially hooking it up with a tower arm. To know more about the landing of Super Heavy, you could click on this I button or check the link in the description. Another major difference between Falcon 9 and the Starship is that the Starship does not need an entry burn, even though it enters from a much higher velocity than Falcon 9 does. Because Falcon Boosters falls in a fairly aerodynamic shape, its velocity is so high that it needs to fire three engines during entry to slow down. Starship is more comparable to the Space Shuttle in re-entry. The main difference is that the Space Shuttle was designed as a glider and thus was moving forward and was controlled with conventional airplane control surfaces, whereas Starship is designed like a skydiver and thus falls straight down and is controlled with four limbs. Next time on Discover Zen, we will be discussing how would SpaceX make rocket fuel on Mars. Thanks for watching our video. If you liked what you saw, click that like and subscribe button. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the Starship free-falling.